Selfless. Any Selfless fans in the crowd?
All right. That sounds pretty good. You know, and shout out to Selfless for not having a sponsor and sticking it out and waiting for a really good offer and not just selling out and getting whatever came to them, because I think that shows they have a lot of self-worth. Oh. But wow, here's Mitch with it. Open up the round.
Yeah, that was on the white van there, and B. Elige trying to get on the catwalk here. Vakusta going to find two. Uber as well getting two. And that's going to be Selfless with three people up, but then Hiko, quick headshot onto Uber. He's all alone right now. One versus two. Nifty from A-Site will take him down, and Selfless, they will come away with a pistol.
That was a bit of an SK pistol. We see that they get away with a lot. I think it was similar to it, but it was also very simple, where they basically just everyone busts out mid on T-side, and it ends up working or it doesn't, but it all depends on whether or not you hit your shots, and that's why we saw that fail and succeed for Selfless, because they were able to hit those one taps.
All right, well, Nifty scoped weapon already. It's going to be the scout, obviously. Most of them have armor. Kusta does not, though. So that could be a one-shot. Nifty jump spotting and looking underpass. And a Liquid just taking their time, spread out across the map, trying to find anything here. There's so many deagles and a lot of time to work on the clock.
Yeah, they spent all their money on here on deagles. And if they had gotten cheaper pistols like P250s, then they would have been able to have nades as well and have made the sacrifice. Now we see Kusta with no armor, and that's because he's going to be picking up the op, and that's how you know.
Yeah, he wants that as quick as possible. Now, Adren did take one shot, flashed Hiko, trying to work out a palace. Nothing really coming of it over here at A. Mainline, meanwhile, holding out in the smokes. There's Relics, quick pick into the connector. He'll bring down Nitro. Nade up. Ooh, actually, quite a bit of damage done over to Hiko right now.
Yeah, it looks like they're pushing aggressively up A ramp, have gained a little bit of map control, but that won't shake Selfless. Oh no, the deagle missing a little bit, but Adren cleans it up with the headshot in the end. You can still call that a one deag, though. Now Nifty answers back with a couple of scout headshots. Wow, not just one, but two. And Uber finally cleans it up. Wow, those were some nice shots right there. And it seemed like they were aggressing into the site. They got across the stairs, and they even killed the connector player. And usually when you play that passively, you're really relying on your players staying alive and then also guaranteeing one frag at the cost of some map control and putting yourself in a little bit more of a precarious position. So that's why we saw them do that. Usually when that player dies without getting a kill, well, it spells trouble, especially on a second round.
So great start already from Selfless, up 2-0, and also they never allowed Liquid to even get the bomb down, so no money going into round number three for them. It's just one smoke on Kusta and everybody sitting on the Glocks. And it looks like it'll be a smoke play onto A. And are those bullet decals to help Kusta line up the smoke? It's what it looks like.
I wish the bomb... I don't know. I feel like it's so much harder to get the bomb across to the site from A ramp than it is from Palace, from where you can just jump out into the site. But we'll see if it works out. Blocks only.
Wow, and that was a dread. And just going out first before anything happened. Maybe trying to get some information before they throw the smoke and telegraph the play. Yeah.
Oh, they're going to hear that damage nade.
Well, here comes the smoke right onto the site. That'll block off Uber's line of sight. But he'll go up onto the ticket. He'll take the high ground. He finds Nitro working on the taps long range, trying to get Kusta off of Tetris. But he's having a hard time with that. Meanwhile, Nifty coming back over and doing things with that scout. A couple nice scout kills for him. Bomb starting to be armed, but Uber will stop that. And Nifty, another scout kill.
Yep, and now they're up 3-0. Liquid just tried to make the most of that round by getting a bomb plant, but couldn't do it. Now, we'll see. It'll be the first rifle that we get to witness, and here's the awesome crowd at DreamHack Austin. They've been fantastic all day long. And there are the focused eyes of Hiko. Actually, it's a leash to have a Galil. He has full nades, though, so that does kind of balance it out. Mid control looking to be taken by Liquid, but slowly.
Then even though Kusta was buying lightly on some of those rounds, we thought to get out to the op early. He's not gone for it. They want to try to get it done with the AKs and utility. And here's Adren coming away with that first kill. He'll bring down Relics. Now just one man over in B for Selfless.
Yeah, so now they have that 5v4. And again, this is, you know, a stat you can look at for basically every pro team. And that's they win most of the rounds that they make at 5v4 naturally. But not only that, they do it about 70 to 80% of the time. So... ooh, I think Adren just spotted Mainline jumping up, but it might have been a two-way street.
Ooh, Mainline was going into the same exact position that Relics died. Maybe trying to get in there unsuspected. Maybe they wouldn't clear it again, but then goes for the pop flashes and nothing really coming of that besides Mainline taking a ton of damage. He's down in the red into 7 HP. The rotations have come into be. There are two here, but look at Nitro getting uncontested up on the catwalk. And wow, B falls so quickly. They get taken out at pretty much the same exact time. And now it's Nifty still working with the scout. That's some confidence and a near headshot into Nitro, but instead it's Nitro to find the headshot. And now Uber, 1v5. If Hiko could get the kill, it's a team ace for Liquid.
So Liquid just played that round out really simply, right? All they did was they followed all the fundamentals. You get your opening frag one way or another. They did that by killing a B player. They cause rotates, then they just wait. They don't show presence. They give a second for rotations to occur, and then they hit a site because time's winding down. Cephalus haven't looked for a frag. So typically you get the kill, you wait for someone to push. If no one pushes, then you make a move on a site through a split, and usually middle is the one that's weak in a situation where you're down a man on Mirage. One of the features of Mirage is so important to keep 5 alive on CT because the CTs get spread thin so easily. So it's really easy once you get one kill to exploit something.
And that's actually pretty scary for Cephalus, right? That round was very important. That's the first rifle, and they got completely decimated. Not even a player going down, hardly even taking any damage on the side of Team Liquid as they'll find their first round. Uber was able to preserve one weapon.
Yeah, it was just straight textbook, and Liquid are just going to continually play that because that's just the best way. That's the way to 80% around, you know, every single time. So no reason not to, and it's really up to Cephalus, by the same token, to try to look for a kill to make it, to even it up. Typically, you don't want to be aggressive 5v5, especially if you have a lot of equipment and stuff like that because your man advantage is so important. But once you're down, that's out the window, and you just need to find a kill and try to bring it back. But that's also why it makes it really easy for the T's to win, because they're on full alert and they can just stand back.
Well, this may work out for Cephalus. They've gone very, very heavy on the mid control. Oh, but that's Uber trying to go for a pop flash into underpass, but still two people are up at the top of middle. They had one on Cat, one in Lana Room, and Uber coming through connector for Cephalus, but it's amounted to nothing. Mitch on Cat gonna get the first kill, maybe the second. He is able to retreat, both of them very, very low, and Relix, oh, it looks like he got aim punched straight up. And Adren will kill Kusta, so I guess we'll say it's gone 1-for-1 there on the catwalk into a 3v3 now.
Yeah, we've got a 3v3. Hiko with the bomb. Middle control is being held by Liquid, and it's up to Cephalus again to try to get some info here. It's not even just because there's three players alive. As we can see, they're all manning a site, and that means that if Liquid group up, it's 3v1 no matter where they go, and we see them congregating towards B at the moment.
Yeah, mainline who started out kind of solo on B. I guess he did have support on Catwalk and two players, but they are gone now. He's holding off with his FAMAS here from Van. Will he be able to come away with the first shot? And it looks like he will. He gets two, actually. Two headshots with the FAMAS from mainline. He goes there, but now he's left 1v2. I mean, he is the clutch meister. It seems like it's possible. Mitch is already low. Molotov's coming out from both teams right there. Hiko taking a little bit of damage. He's pushed off. Goes to peek the window, and maybe that Molotov actually kind of interfering with the vision. He crosses over here to Catwalk, and they have no idea. So Hiko gets that first kill. Now it's a 1v1, but Nifty coming through with the op and Cephalus. They will bounce back after losing the first rifle. It's 4-1.
So what's demanded of you when you're a solo side player in a 3v3 is to get two kills, right? If you go 1-for-1, it's a 2v2 afterplant, which favors the T's by far. But instead, mainline goes 2-for-1, as we see this really awesome FAMA spray, getting two headshots really quickly, dropping the bomb, and then Hiko trades him out. But it's once it's a 2v1 retake, getting that instant trade like Nifty did is just what you got to do. And it's expected of you because it's pretty easy.
And oh wow, some very, very aggressive play here from Cephalus. We saw them kind of posture for mid control in the last round, and now just straight up aggressive into the B side of the map through the tunnels there. This has, however, let Liquid take full mid control.
Yeah, this is a problem. Now the thing is that this setup might actually be fine for Cephalus in the sense that they know they're giving up mid, right? They're allowing people to come into them. And whoa, Kusta just picking Booth at the exact right moment, getting a kill as well.
We're going to try to pop flash and push the smoke, but it's going to be Adren who finds him, kills him basically for free, and then Elige through window room takes down Mitch, and then his legs taken out from under him. That's Relix with the kill there. Mainline also alive. It's 2v4. Cephalus in a pretty bad spot.
Yeah, this is going to be a really difficult retake. The thing is, they're both coming in from the best retake spots, except once Liquid find out that no one's coming from CT, they're going to see that it's either big flank or they're saving. And it seems like, for some reason, Cephalus are still going to go for this, even 2v4 with this much time left. And Hiko, wow, too aware. So he clears a ramp with careful patience because he's so aware that the two like typical spots where you would retake from are just completely clear. So it was a little bit too obvious.
So now just Relix here at the start of Palace, trying to hold on. It looks like they are maybe coming to clear this. Two people working into spawn over from the B side, and then one man on the A ramp there. Relix might be hard-pressed to survive, and it is Nitro that takes him down. No weapons to be saved.
To give them the benefit of the doubt, I maybe need to assume that they weren't actually going for the... They wanted to do some damage because they're up 4-1, and they weren't actually going for the retake, which seemed like just really unrealistic at the time. Like, you would... I would hope, think to save in that situation, but I'm not sure what they were thinking for sure. Now, Selfless are the ones on the save, and actually, even though they were planning to do some damage, were risking their guns and wouldn't have guns to recycle this round, so it's probably not a good idea to be that close to the site in the first place.
More aggression here for Selfless, but you'd expect it on a round like this. Not much into it, just some pistols. They've all pushed on the catwalk, and Elijah will kill mainline. Where have they gone? Underpass, I think, and maybe ladder room. As Mitch, getting taken out by Nitro. That was under the window, and Adren finding another kill. So Liquid, not even taking a point of damage yet. Looking very dominant here in round 7. And B is clear, but they're going to spend some more utility just to make sure none of those pesky pistol players are hiding out in any corners.
They understand the value that that Selfless seek in trying to drop any weapons that they can on a round where they have nothing to lose. Apart from a Deagle and a P250, and now holding for exits, it's gonna be Selfless, but also might be trying to get a little bit aggressive here. Oh, that was a close one. Either way, Selfless are gonna have to move on to a new round where Liquid were able to save 5 guns. So that does wonders for their economy. So that's really good for Liquid because even if they lose, they're gonna be able to have another buy up, especially easy on the T side. Even if you do lose a couple players, but on a flawless eco, this could turn into a situation where you not only don't have to recycle guns, but or buy new guns, but you can also have full grenades.
Something I've noticed for Liquid is almost every single player on every round is getting a kill. Mm. Like, at least 4 players have got a kill, I think, on the last 2 or 3 rounds. So everyone just kind of doing their thing, hitting their shots. And here it's a team ace, right? Hugo gets that last kill on the Lurk. I mean, not an important kill to get, but it goes to further prove the point there.
Yeah. Now they move into a rifle round, and Selfless, you know, they're up 4-1. They've won one rifle round, however, and that score might be a little bit misleading in that way. But they've still got time and options. Actually, they don't even have money here, so it seems like a double save is in the books, where Liquid will be able to not only even up, but also build up their economy in such a big way.
And Selfless have been getting so aggressive out towards middle, even on one of the rifle rounds, and then now on both of these ecos, either going middle or coming off catwalk to middle. I wonder if that'll start to get a bit predictable. Here it's worked out somewhat better as Hiko and Acusta have been taken down, so it's a 3-on-3. Actually, HP advantage to Selfless, and mainline with an op can keep this very, very interesting.
Ooh, good flash on Uber. He's in kind of a good spot. He might be able to see ahead before it sees him, and he does find the first kill. He's looking for a second. Will he get it? No, Adren trades him out, and they're on the site, but it's 2v3. Elige very low as well, has a smoke. Adren full maze as well, and they're going to have to put this utility to work because their health is not looking good.
That nade actually hurt Adren pretty badly, and here's Mitch. We saw him actually with some nice one deegs from that Gfinity event, and of course the joking Selfless video, the highlights, but... Whew. Oh, nicely done. So Mitch gets one, and it's mainline, who I believe gets a kill, picks up the op, and then ends the round with that op.
He actually got 2 kills on A-site, killed both a rifle and an opper with no armor, and then came over to be in... and got the final frag in the 2v1. That's a huge round for, like, think about like how we were talking about that round right before it happened, and that was that Selfless had a round where they had to basically forfeit and also allow Liquid to build off by just giving the kills up because they had no half armor, anything, right? They really weren't even supposed to come close to winning that round, let alone get 5 kills and actually put a round on the board for them, so. Now Liquid, are in a really rough spot. They had a free round to win, and it seems like Selfless are starting to pick the heat back up. And the thing is that they have been getting outclassed on a couple of these rifle rounds. I still think Liquid have won more than they have. But that being said, it's really on Selfless to put together a good CT half.
Definitely. Where I feel like the CT side of Mirage does come down to a lot of teamwork and communication, just because you always got to make sure someone's watching your back, especially on the A site and out in middle. So it'll be a good test for Selfless and their team motto as we see them now. They've got to be pretty pumped after winning that round. Putting nothing into it and winning, that really helps stimulate that CT economy. As you can see, money left over after a full buy coming out here in round 9.
Now we have Liquid going right back into a default. We know that they like mid control. I think both teams know this is no secret, but Uber wins the fight in underpass, even versus the Flash, though it's two kills to come out for Liquid, and now Nifty answers back, making it a 3v3, a really tough spot. But Uber continuing the push. Will he be spotted? Knows he has the bomb, and maybe also is aware that Adren has pushed through halls. Or Nitro, that is.
Yeah, do they know about Nitro? Uber was pushing through over to the TV room, but now just holding an angle on the bomb, and it could come down to timing, and it's going to work out better for Uber as he finds Nitro looking the wrong way. Relics as well over at A, brings down Hiko, and it's just Kusta 1v3, so Selfless starting off quite good here.
Well, quite a good time to push underpass. I mean, he got away with it. He also caught whoever was off guard, and wow, there it is. Kusta to get one kill, and now it's a 1v2. They do have the bomb. Do they have the time, however? 20 health now on Kusta. He's actually spotted both players. I don't know if he knows it. He could run back to the other site if he so desired.
I think he should know. He got tagged with an op and then shot at by an AK. So he should be able to maybe assume that they are both there. And time on the clock is about 30 seconds. Just missing that shot. The player jumping away. Relics realizing what's up. That Kusta could just move to the other site. So he's putting himself in a decent spot to stomp this. But Kusta is so aware right now. What a shot onto Relics. Nifty was going that way. And he's thinking, all right, my teammate just died here. I'll push through. And he's taking a P250 versus an op right now.
He knows
I think
that.
The call came out, yeah, that Kusta is low. Nifty's the one that did the damage.
Oh, Nifty actually walking all the way around the site. This is probably going to catch Kusta off guard, and good patience from Nifty. Knew he actually didn't move, and I mean, maybe would have assumed that he could have pushed CT. That would have been the value in taking that risk for Kusta, but he seemed pretty dead set on the CT rotate and was wrong about it. Either way, 1v3 almost came down to a situation where they shouldn't have even come close to losing it. They even had bomb control and allowed Kusta to get two frags and a plant.
Yeah, I think maybe they should have given up the bomb control at that point and just played on the sites, because you're kind of in that really small area where Kusta can just hit those shots. Not much to aim at in that hallway. And Kusta nearly did it. But nope, Selfless. They get the round. They lead 6-3 right now. And a P90 comes out for Uber.
Yeah, we still have that buy, and we see the ecos that Liquid have had to themselves thing off pretty well. They've gotten two buys in a row, even though they're down 3-6. Uber actually has a P90. Where's he playing? Huh. Rotating through B halls. I wonder where he's going to dedicate himself. And we saw him at Van that one round where he was able to get the P250 frags that led into mainline winning the round. But now they've got three players on B. They've seen the B splits over and over again, and they're just trying to make a read based on the patterns that they've noticed. And that is kind of how you want to play this game, right? People will always adhere to tendencies that they've gotten away with in the past, at least most of the time, right? And so that's what is the foundation for your read, unless you think that they're just going to do something different for no reason, or maybe to stay one step ahead of you. But Liquid are just passively looking for information, and actually looks like the B split might be imminent. Lurk up A ramp, however.
Liquid aren't finding any of that information, and the time is getting low. The majority of them, as well as the bomb, are over towards B. But here's Kusta going up on the double boxes on catwalk. He takes a really nice shot onto Uber, so now man advantage, and I think the execute's coming out. Well, they expect two more, and the rotations are already underway. It looks like Nifty maybe getting cold feet. He's going to hold out at A for a bit longer, but Relics has committed to this. He's in the market. Meanwhile, Kusta going to work. He takes down Mitch, his second kill of the round. Now Legion Adren will team up to find Relics. Mainline almost stopping. Does stop the plant. Time is in the red. Nifty is in the wrong part of town to stop this bomb from going down, and it will. With 2 seconds remaining on the clock, and Nifty thinking maybe it went down over here at A, which seems a bit odd.
You know, the read was there, but we had too many players die without answer. Maybe they should have allowed Liquid to aggress into the site even more than they already had. I know they already were up cat, and they had to worry about the B split through halls, but the issue was that, you know, not even getting the kill and staying alive, which would have meant taking a duel face-to-face, but not even the latter, not even just simply staying alive on site. So, you know, it put Mainline in a tough spot, right? He had a guaranteed one kill spot, and he's a third man on the site, so they would almost certainly not clear it because they wouldn't expect it to have been read so hard. But because his teammates died without getting killed before then, it's kind of like, okay, I can get a kill, but can I kill five people from here? Absolutely not. That would never happen. So No, this is, they're actually going tit for tat. It's kind of impressive from Selfless. Like, they're doing really well. I'm sure they, again, they've had pretty good results versus NA teams. It's just not, they've never actually got to play NA teams on LAN, so maybe this is going to be a good positive experience for them.
Well, hopefully for Selfless, they can maybe find themselves a map so that just they can get more experience and maybe even continue to win in advance. But Nifty, he was able to stay alive, so he's got the AWP once more. Deagles are going to come out, as well as some P250s for the other members of Selfless. But look at Nitro. Thought he got both of those. Just the second one. Kusta finds the first kill of the round, and everyone else following up with a kill. And this is what I'm talking about again. Every single person on Liquid gets a kill in this round.
Yeah, it's a team effort on Liquid. And somehow, even though with these ecos, like, Selfless still have a lead. That's so surprising to me. I think Liquid have won two rifles. They actually won maybe three. I think all of the rounds they've won have been rifles, apart from one eco. There was one eco where they're able to clean up. That was a double save, in which the second round Selfless managed to convert with no armor.
Well, here's Nifty. Let's see what he can do. A little bit of time to warm up with the op. A nice quick shot onto Elige. We'll take him off of the catwalk. Nifty's location, though, is now known. And just giving up that angle, maybe a moment too soon. Heard those footsteps, maybe didn't realize that they were an underpass and not on the catwalk. He's still not taking a shot. He's just going to go down and hide in the smoke. That's where the Molotovs can't get you. And oh, he backed up a little too far. Kusta will put an op bullet through him.
Wow, and Kusta has been doing a fantastic job on T side. And on these rifle rounds, he's able to get the kills, open up the round, turn one kill into two. He's looking like Simple right now. And that's not something you would think you would say about a player who was forfeiting the T side off to Simple to play CT side. But now, he has no one to share that responsibility with and seems to be stepping up in a big way.
Mainline aggressive through underpass once more, and he goes with the teammate. Relix is there to help him out, but Nitro kills them both, and that's basically the round. That really hurts for Selfless to get aggressive and have it just be shut down that hard and by one player.
That was that's a huge commitment to put two players in underpass. I mean, it makes sense if you want to go for the trades, but ultimately, you know that Liquid go late top mid, and if you have someone going underpass to meet them, you have to get B Hall's control. So they were looking to crush it, but they didn't send anyone else through apps to come and shoot the players at the top of the stairs on the side of the head. Instead, they sent two players into the same angle. One of them peaked way too soon, and that just gave Liquid a 5v3. I mean, at best, I guess they were assuming they would get two or three kills and stay alive, but it seems unrealistic now, considering how well Liquid dealt with it.
And it would appear that Selfless, even after giving up B, just kind of started pushing through A, maybe in an effort to just get on the flank quicker, but I think ultimately just get into positions to save these guns right away. They knew the round was going to be near impossible and that their economy is in danger of collapse, so Liquid take five people onto an undefended bombsite.
Yeah, no, you might think, why did Selfless forfeit one bombsite after being down 5v3? Like, they should spread out. Well, in reality, you have to take a risk. Sometimes that means pushing something, but sometimes that also means stacking something. And the contingency plan is that if they go to the wrong site, we'll just save. And Liquid realized this and know that they're probably in the best safe positions they can be in, but ooh, are gonna have to get these kills.
Nifty maybe not quite as blind as they would have liked, and Mitch nearly finding a double kill with that FAMAS. Nifty, oh my goodness, I don't know if he sees him or the round's ending, so he takes a shot, but it does connect. And the three members there of Selfless will survive, so small prize, but ultimately they lose the round.
Yeah, really good save from Selfless there to keep three alive. And they'll move into this round with three rifles. That's going to also warrant a buy. Relix is the only one who's a little bit low, and Nifty seeing an opportunity right now. The Molly's not the Molly's not touching him top connector, so he's like, I'm gonna look over top of that.
So Nifty continuing to hit nice shots there. He'll bring out Elige, but then it's Nitro from behind. Goes unchecked through middle, comes up the connector and gets that kill. Now he's gonna work furthermore onto the A site. Relix actually goes down to Adren. Uber now up on balcony, was able to get one, tries to pull off the spin move, but Nitro is quicker. And a mainline with FAMAS once more making his rotation over. It does bring the bomb down. It actually falls pretty close to him in CT. So 2-on-2 right now. That flash caught Kusta in the face. And it's mainline and Mitch. Mitch, he's known. He's going to have to extinguish that real quick, and he does. It's Mitch who's in the better spot, but Kusta too quick. Takes him down with an op headshot. Hiko started spraying as soon as mainline jumped out. It was a little unfortunate for him in mainline in a 1v2. I think the op of Kusta is going to be the difficult part. Hiko on 9 HP, maybe you can deal with that. And he does, actually. The flash was so effective that Kusta couldn't help out with the trade. And up on the boxes, he nearly goes down. 23 HP right now to 26, but it's Kusta with the Tech 9 going in and getting it done. Rolling up those sleeves, Launders.
It really did just come down to bullets in the last 2v, in that 2v1. Everybody knew each other's spots, and it was mainly about when do I peek, and can I win this timing fight, and how do I do the damage necessary to just make it a 1v1? Mainline almost came away with that win. Kusta, with a rare miss, almost cost him his life, but ultimately Liquid come out ahead and now take a lead in this half. 7-6 now on their T side. They've got to be feeling a little bit better now.
Yeah, I believe that's it. Four rounds in a row for Liquid, and the mid-aggression, I think, starting to become very expected. Although, Alish does actually take a fall. So 4-on-4. Mainline surviving on just 8 HP as Liquid will take it slow. They don't want to run into any more pistol traps.
Yeah, certainly not. I mean, not getting eco'd is a talent in itself these days, but it still doesn't mean it should happen. Liquid, we see they give the opposite side of the map a lot more attention. I call it the opposite side of the map because A is pretty much where 70% of T rounds end up going down to, right? Like mid control into A splits are typically the hardest to deal with. Cat splits are really good, but there's so many counters to them. You require so many more smokes as a terrorist to get up cat. Just one top mid, one in front of connector on cat. You need a molly in connector, you need a smoke in window. Whereas a connector split could be as simple as, smoke top mid across boxes, one on cat, get someone in connector, and then go 4-1 through A ramp. Wow.
Oh, wow.
Still aware Kusta.
Like, I don't know if that was Kusta being quick or Relix just didn't quite react. Maybe he was looking at the minimap or going over some comms. But he gets taken down real quick. Nifty so far unable to do anything with that Deagle. We saw him working for something over at B. Uber, what? Dropping the hammer right there with the jump scout off the trash can. That'll bring down Hiko. No way to fight back against that. Uber now very flashed as they will push through the smoke, and Nitro will deal with that, saying no more jump scouting, please. And here's Nifty. Maybe a chance to find one of those one Deegs, but the bomb has been planted. Doesn't really need to save. You can just try to go for this. Nitro's too fast.
Now, I got ahead selfless. I don't know how they've managed to get six rounds while Liquid have also gotten so many ecos off of them, but it seems like they've put together a half that means that they've won quite a few rifle rounds, and I have to look back and see to really draw that story up, but wow, what a shot from Hooper jump scouting from the dump or the garbage can. And now we're moving into the last round of the half. I mean, there's potential for Liquid to get nine rounds here, which is a very good half considering their 1-4 start.
What a well-placed nade there onto Nifty. Yeah, it was Hiko the one that threw it there in A Palace, just expecting the op to be put up there. And now Mitch dealing with two players over B. Oh, he tries to go for the hop around into the window to get in front of that smoke. But he does miss the jump, and maybe that saved his life and doesn't actually allow him to come away with one kill. He'll bring down Kusta. And now Mitch, he's got support. Uber's made his rotation over from that catwalk, so coming to help out. Mitch now jump spotting for some of that info. I don't think he'll go for that again.
Liquid have been giving B attention a lot this half, and I think that's no secret to Selfless. We still have two here. Good nades being used. I like how Mitch is continually giving attention to Biaps and not letting anyone aggress too far up. Nitro, the underpass player, getting spotted as well. And it's really good on Selfless to fall off of these kills. It's important to peek, but it's also important to stay alive, so they've got to find a harmony there, and it seems like they're doing a good job of that.
Well, Relix and Mainline now both trying to take over middle. They're still smoked off of Cat and smoked off of Window Room, but not for much longer. The Window one just now going to dissipate, and oh, they actually kill each other!
That's one way to blow and that's, 5v5.
That's the confusion of the smokes, and yeah, no longer a 5v4, it's now a 4-on-4, and that's a very, very awkward for Selfless here on the last round of the first half. Nitro gonna spot one coming out of the vent and somehow losing that one. Relix gets that kill. Nifty's flash, I think it did go over the ticket booth. Yeah, it did. Nothing to follow it up though. As Alish takes down Relix and he's looking for more. Expecting one to come through the vent, just misses. Uber dropping out of the window actually. 3-on-2, Selfless. Bomb is planted, so they're on the retake, but they've got the man advantage. And here's Hiko behind Firebox, gonna play with the first kill. Smoke is down. Elige helping out from over in Connector. That was actually on the catwalk where he took down Uber. And Hiko going for the Tech 9. Nifty has tapped that, but he's not on the bomb. He's looking for the op shots, but Hiko's in too close with the Tech 9.
I don't know what happened just now. I'd like to watch that back, but Relic's giving up that kill in that 5v4 when they were playing it so well across the board. Obviously, he probably saw his teammate and just it was in a spot where he didn't expect him to be and hit his first bullet, unfortunately, for his teammate. But now, I mean, that almost cost him a round. It's in part due to that, but still, Selfless have a 6-round half. It's not the worst thing in the world. They get to move into CT side. They might be more comfortable. Overall, I think everyone knows that Liquid are the favorites, but Selfless on home turf with their opponents today.
Well, I mean, this half already quite a bit closer than what we witnessed earlier in the other NA versus NA matchup, where it was 14-1. At least this is a 9-6, but now Liquid get to go over to the CT side. Hiko with utility, Kusta as well. He's got the HE and the kit. 4 armor for Selfless, just a flash. 2 flashes, I think, there on Nifty. And they're holding off. This B rush is coming in so quick. Elige is able to hit one. Hiko actually coming up empty-handed. Elige still trying to hold them. And now Kusta rotating over, tosses in a nade, gets a kill, and Elige just playing this perfectly, staying alive, being a nuisance. The bomb will go down. Should be the round for Liquid, thanks in part to Elige. And Elige actually finds one more. Make that a triple kill, and it's Nifty at bench with the P250 trying to get it done, but Nitro won't let him.
No, we have traded pistols, and we see the B hit not pay off. The saving grace here is that Selfless were able to get a plant, so that means they can either do an early buy or actually buy right here, but no matter what they do, they're causing Liquid to spend more money than they like to. There's a lot of power in that. So the plant on the second round is great. If they're able to get 2 plants in a row, that means op on the following round, and it's kind of understood by Liquid what that could mean. But we actually have a buy zone spotting. I don't know when the last time we've seen that weapon used since I think like Get Right like last year. You know, like it's just not that good versus armor. It has a lot of bullets, but you're expecting the team to save.
Oh my goodness, the fire taking away some of their money. They would have rather had the SMG kills, and there's the Bison coming in, 64 bullets. How can you argue with that? Who doesn't want more bullets?
Yeah, anticipating the fact that because Selfless were able to get the plant, that they were gonna, instead of a kind of a janky buy where they get Tech 9 armor and then full nades, where they do some kind of cheap or low cost of a execute, that they would save up for this round. And they were right about it. Now we have that buy coming out Selfless. Not able to get that plant last round. We see that's affecting the amount of utility that they have here. They've only got a couple of flashes. Only 1 smoke, actually, on Nifty. So that means they're going to have to make that go a long way. I don't know how he's going to use it, but it seems like he's posted up at A ramp with the bomb as well. This might be foreshadowing as to how this round is going to end if it goes the way Selfless wants it to.
Well, maybe they'll have a bit more luck. They don't have the utility, but I think Nitro has picked up the Bison now and taking that into the first rifle here, round 18 in the second half. Selfless are playing it slow. We've got just the 1 smoke actually on Nifty, so they can't even set up for the full A execute.
Yeah, huge equipment value advantage for Liquid. Nitro. Did you just point that out? Nitro,
yeah,
still has
he still has the Bison. Hiko dropped it to him and bought his M4. Which is pretty comical.
Yeah, playing Cat, like the most frag-heavy spot on the map with one of the worst possible guns you could have, maybe the worst possible gun you could have versus armor. 3 headshots total just to take someone down, depending on the range.
All right, they're just going to try to get it done with the flashes. That pushes Adren back. He will be flashed once more. See, these are team flashes that are flashing him, but they're very effective. Selfless being slowed down quite a bit. Although Mitch with the Galil finds the first kill of the round. That's onto Kusta. Nitro going over the stairs. Does a bit of damage. Adren's killed one with fire, and the bomb's being planted. Nitro working around triple, actually getting shot in the back because there's mainline. At the triple box, he'll find a second. Oh, nearly pulls off the spin to get the third, but Hiko is cleaned up, and Selfless will find themselves another round.
The early buy pays off. I actually thought that was really cool. Like, they just did a CT smoke, and they relied on having a lot of flashes come out, and it seemed like they were really well placed because it pushed Liquid into positions that I don't think they wanted to be. I'm a little bit too passive. And even though that buy zone was bought, Nitro has 4K, but his rest of his teammates can't meet him even a quarter of the way and put together some sort of buy. It looks like they're just going off of pistols, no half armor, low nades. We saw Selfless convert a similar round. Let's hope that doesn't happen again, and to them. because they've got a long trek back, even if they do come away with this eco, but it's really nice that they have a chance to try and build up their economy now.
So Kusta's pushed through in Palace. He's getting some information. That's led Liquid to then just transition most of their players over into B. We got three in there. Kusta, of course, pushed up in a Liege, kind of holding out in CT spawn by window. Nitro gets fired. Oh, they saw him as well. So he's taking a bit of damage. He's down to 14. And Selfless continue to use their nades, trying to avoid, again, those pistol traps that can be very, very hard to deal with sometimes.
Well, looks like we have someone pushed into A halls. That's Kusta. I don't know. Is that an egg? That looks like a hard fight to win versus a rifle end. Oh, he actually gets the headshot off on Relic, so will he look for more blood? It looks like he's going to come out spraying. And doesn't get the kill, but sees three people. Hiko on the other side of the map, however, has made it a 4v4, and Elysian in a good spot in CT.
Yeah, Selfless rotated off of B and just left Mitch there, but Mitch gets killed almost immediately, so that gives Hiko an AK right now. Long-range CZ from Elige, almost denying the bomb plant, and before that he did get one kill. Uber with the double to answer back, though, and now it's just Hiko. No armor, but he has an AK. He's smoked off, so he can't go up the stairs, but this is often pre-aimed, so that'll be tough. Spots the man at Firebox, coming away with that kill somehow. Nifty unable to any response.
I was going to say, he should just save. Like, he should totally save. He has no armor. He just picked up an AK. They're going to buy next round. That'll be really nice that he can drop that, make sure everyone has full nades, and then he almost ends up getting the second kill, and I'm like, what? But, yeah, doing a little bit of damage there, making it costly. And we have some dabbing in the crowd.
It's actually quite full in here. I'm impressed. As Kusta, oh, a little slow on the uptake, tries to go for the flick, and then he's tagged up and taken down through the boards. So Mitch with the first headshot and the opening kill of the round there. That's Kusta down. And Liquid, I mean, no one else was even playing the A site at that point.
Versus that specific execute, Kusta should have been a huge thorn on their side, and then Mitch just neutralized them without even taking any damage. So that's an enormous entry.
Now the retake is on. They're a man down. They've actually used some utility already. The one smoke going out, that's for CT. Oh no, sorry, that's for Palace. And Balcony, so they're trying to work their way in. Now Mainline finds one, but it's Nitro over the stairs, and then a Dren here for Liquid on the retake. Nitro, oh, too many at Tetris for him to deal with. Now a Dren far away, spraying from the top of Ticket, gets one. He's picked up a smoke as well. They know where this last player might be, but Nifty peeks too quickly, and he won't take him down. Now Hiko out of time, trying to run away, trying to get out of dodge, spots the op, does live, and he will go back for it.
Wow, a 4v5 retake on A where they almost got all the kills necessary. It was pretty close, but it was really nice and just an excellent kill for Mitch. I mean, it's literally the round in that kill because they rely on Kusta to stay alive in CT. It's a pretty safe spot. It's not even a huge risk to put him there, and he gets killed in pretty much the worst way possible. Misses a shot and gives up that section of the map completely. The bomb goes down, and it was a nice plant. It wasn't a plant for CT, which would have been bad considering how close Liquid were to winning that. Based on it coming from CT.
Mainline, the one player in this round with the MAC-10 is supposed to go out and get the information, but he runs into the one person that has the op, and Kusta will not miss that shot, so that's the first kill. The rest of Selfless, meanwhile, starting to execute onto A. Relics trying to go for the double entry, but Kusta denying that. Kusta with two kills on the round. Mitch, one quick through the smoke, and then another through the flames. That's onto Elige. Three on two. Flash over Kusta through triple box. He brings down Mitch. It looks like he's got the read that someone's trying to get back into fire.
Will he peek over this? Oh, he sees the Molotov come across. He knows that a duel is imminent, but that kill's not being given up. However, Nitro with the MAC-10 on the flank finds one, and now the AK is spotted pushing off of the box, and Uber realizes he has to make it a 1v1, but can't. 4K on the round for Kusta and a round win for Liquid. 12-9 now.
Don't forget that Kusta's actual name is Kenny S.
That's true,
and
yeah.
He comes away with the 4K. He's the only one on the team with a proper rifle, the op in this case. Everyone else is just pistols, and he steps up, gets the 4K. Some ridiculous shooting. It looks like we'll have another look. This is the one where he's blind, but gets through the triple box there. And then this nice shot as Uber tries to cross out, move his position. Kusta not allowing that.
Young Kenneth Suin.
And he's going to just try to keep chaining this momentum together. Mid smoked out really quick. He'll throw a fire to upper mid. But that's just misdirection right now from Selfless. We can see that they are geared up and ready to go B, possibly somewhat quickly. Yep, here comes the play, telegraphed by the smokes. Hiko hiding out. Does he have a flash to use? He won't worry about it. He'll just stay on the M4. And they won't even check it. He gets one, two, three, four, five. That's the ace from Hiko.
What an insane spray in the A4 commercial as he gets all five kills with 30 bullets. Amazing shooting from Hiko to seal up the 13th round.
Wow, and that's a force by two. Upgraded pistols and the armor and all those kills coming in so quick. You can see Mitch can't get out of the window. And that's a clip there for Hiko. And now Kusta once more goes back out to middle. And here's Selfless with, I mean, even less than they had the last round. Call it a deco, maybe. They had three deagles. And yeah, I don't think it's going to end well for the man. That's Nifty at the top of mid. Yeah, Kusta knew he was there, and he will get the second off kill of the round. Uber on underpass. Nitro will drop down. Death from above. And Kusta with the third. Kusta and Hiko in the last couple rounds.
If we look back on this game, we're going to see a lot of save rounds on the side of Selfless, and we see that that's basically because, not because they're losing like a lot of rounds in general, they're just on the rounds they're losing. They've just been so economically beat down by either Liquid saving a lot on their rifles or being able to do a lot of damage on their ecos. And now there's a tactical pause coming out. At a good time, they had two ecos to work with, but it's always better to simply take this time before an actual rifle round to save your pause. Because, like, right after you lose a rifle round, right, we see so often, right after someone loses a rifle round, they go into a pause. And from the spectator view, you're like, why are you using this pause right now when it's not even going to be a rifle around next round, so you're not even going to be able to use what you just talked about, and maybe people forget what to do at that point. So it's a really good call, I think, to wait out the eco rounds, then call the pause, get your thoughts together, and work from there.
Well, whatever Snuffles come up with, it's going to have to work, because Liquid just one round now off of match point here on Mirage.
To be honest, like, Selfless have done a good job of winning a lot of rifle rounds. Like, there's a lot of good to say about what the rounds that they've won. They've also traded pistols, so, you know, that hasn't influenced their score that greatly. Overall, I'd say if we looked at Liquid scoreline, we see maybe just as many rifle rounds won, but more important ones, and that those have resulted in saves. We've literally seen double saves twice from Selfless. I mean, you can't expect them to maintain a positive scoreline versus Liquid when that's the case.
I mean, Selfless were staying with them early on in the half, right? They got the pistol, quick 3-0, dropped the first rifle, but then won the next one, dropped two more, and then were very fortunate to actually come back with the full eco round that they won, remember? Mm-hmm. That kind of kept them in it, but once they got the six rounds, they kind of stagnated a bit, and it was Team Liquid that ran away with the first half 9-6. Mm-hmm. And then since we've seen Selfless on the T side, they haven't really been able to get much of anything done.
Yeah, they had the one round where Mitch was able to run up a ramp. They had one, like, fully execute that ended up being, that I think they converted into a round. That actually might have been the same one. One thing we haven't seen is that is Selfless, like, taking advantage of mid-control more or less. Like, we've seen them all group up B-apps. We've seen them do full A hits. And they do have presence at mid, but they aren't really utilizing it to the point that I think they could put more pressure on Liquid from, like, if they were able to get up into get someone lurking in connector or someone lurking in the ladder room, they might be able to put one player to work. But I think they're mostly relying on having some basic form of map control, hoping that Liquid push, and then just setting up for an execute whether or not they get a kill.
Which is kind of weird because we saw Selfless put so much pressure on mid when they were on the CT side. But the same can't really be said for the T side so far.
Ironically, they've done more aggressive pushes on their CT side, like the double underpass. They'd underpass twice.
They pushed top mid a bunch as well. That one was generally more when they were on ecos or force buys. That's how they got one of their rounds. As now all of Selfless are grouping up here. It's just Nifty who's gone into Palace. The other four all ready to go.
Once again, 5v5, bread and butter A hit. Four players A ramp. This can be really bad if people throw mollies A ramp. This can just shut down your whole hit, and we'll see if that happens. Kusta, however, post up with the op, is not going to be throwing counter nades.
Well, he does get it out, though, very quickly. As soon as he unscoped. But look at this wall of smoke. I don't think CT was smoked, actually. They were looking to maybe take that battle and set us to the connector and a couple smokes around this site, so a little bit different. You know, all the smokes through the site. Mitch finds one. Elige does answer back, and look at the bomb. It's not planted. It's just down on the ground, and things are going to get chaotic here. Nifty with a nice shot. Here's Elige coming up the ladder and does react accordingly. And man, that's Hiko, I believe, with the deagle on flank and Palace.
Our number two man in window. He's the man to watch. They got three players on the site, but he's got to open up a choke point for them so they can get the bomb down. Adren's going to take this fight as well, and he gets the kill on Uber. That's a huge frag. Hiko as well on the flank is going to spot one person falling out of Palace. And the bomb actually goes down, but he might find a second kill. No, Relix trades him out. Now it's 1v2.
Yeah, he was unaware that Relix was at ramp. It's Good thing Relic's got that kill. Now it's all on Adren. That fire not forcing Nifty to move, so he'll just hold tight on the box. No reason to peek. They know Adren's got the op. It's all on Adren right now. He spots one at Tetris. They keep on peeking. He's seeing blood. Adren knows he's pulled out the pistol. And he's gonna drop a smoke here. He's got that kit. He will take down Relics. And he's gonna get onto the bomb. Nifty's got an op, and the knife's coming through. 1500 bucks for Nifty and another round for Selfless.
Yeah, and Nifty was definitely the man of that round as he got that kill on someone. Did he get the kill on Hiko or
Relics killed Hiko?
Oh no, it was Elise. Elise comes out balcony and Nifty's posted on connector and he gets the kill on he gets that kill and gets the final kill in the 1v1 as well. Super huge. But yeah, as you mentioned, they were peaking a little bit too much, I'd say. Especially considering what they had going on. A good crossfire, but the bomb was planted at triple, so it wasn't that easily defended by our man at Tentris, and that's maybe why he was putting his life at risk.
Well, Kusta, he smokes the top of, or shoots through the smoke at the top of middle, then Molotov's out to the island box there. So that delays Selfless taking mid control, but they've got it now. They're going to make sure no one's in the window, but Nitro is up there in ladder room, and Kusta's repositioned. He's peeking straight into that angle. I mean, that's just a case of pre-fire. Kusta took some damage, but he comes away with the kill, and now Nitro, he goes right back up into the ladder room here. Nicely played by him. And look at Adren up on top of the base, spotting the shadow first. So he'll beat out Relics, no problem. Now it's just Uber and Nifty left for Selfless.
So much map control, so much information, and you really don't think that's the case because it's you know, Selfless to take the most info in mid, but Liquid have a pincer move going on. Nitro giving up that kill, but traded out by Hiko. Won't matter too much now. Nifty 1v4.
Yeah, it was a nice shot by Uber, but Hiko was right there to make sure it didn't get out of hand. And Nifty pretty much set up on a Mission Impossible.
Yeah, he's got 30 seconds left to work with, and you know, the thing is that you can save in this situation, but you're going to be really hard-pressed to find that CTs don't come looking for you early once they know it's like so many players alive and you haven't tried to make a move. Now, it's really on Liquid to decide whether or not they want to move out early and try to find him, but they also don't want to forfeit this round, so.
And look at Kusta and Hiko. I think that was everyone's picks, right, of the players to watch? 25 kills and 23 kills each. Mm-hmm. So they are more than carrying their weight there. Nifty not having a bad game for himself either at 19 and 14. And he will be able to preserve the op here. But that's match point for Liquid now.
Yeah, they leave the op in play, and you know, Liquid are fully aware of this, but at the same time, they move on to match point. They kept four alive there, so their economy's in a great spot. Nifty's money hasn't moved, so that means that his team will have to buy behind it, and we see that means that they're only going to have Tech Nines. I mean, it's the best case situation considering it'll be last round no matter what, but last round if they lose, that is.
Well, we saw Kusta in a similar situation get all the kills with the op. Can Nifty do it now for Selfless to keep them in this best of one on Mirage? They're in the group stages. Nitro brings down mainline. Kusta's shot onto Mitch. Nicely done. Not letting him cross an Uber. Oh my goodness. What a shot there from Kusta. And now it's Hiko back at the white van, finding a double kill.
Wow.
And that will be that.